There's actually a ton of different applications when it comes to solar and applying it to your life. And not only is it cool to learn about them and how they can impact you and change your life, but it's also really, really important that you're clear on your goal with solar when you're trying to properly size and build out a kit. It's also just impossible to shop for a solar power system when most companies have them labeled based on their application, like hybrid, off-grid, and you don't even know what those things mean yet. It makes it very difficult. So what is up, you guys? Welcome back to the lab. Today you are in video 3 of a very short little playlist of videos that we put together to help you guys understand the fundamentals, terms, and ultimately how to properly build an off-grid solar power system that suits your needs. If at any point you find these videos helpful, make sure that you share them with some friends. We have nothing to sell you guys. We just want to provide information that we did not have access to when we were trying to learn this stuff. And in this third video, we're going to be taking a look at the different types of systems and applications so that you can ultimately choose the one that fits your life best and know that that's what you're kind of geared towards going forward when you start doing math on what parts and components and things that you need to buy to get yourself set up. We went ahead and broke these down into 4 major categories that we're going to go over today, starting with the first one, which is what the majority of this playlist that we've put together is built towards, which is off-grid. Off-grid, plain and simple, means you are off of the grid. Now, most people think of off-grid as a cabin somewhere out in Alaska, which technically is true. But if we live in a house like we do right now, and we have power coming in from a power line from the street, and we were just to cut our affiliation with that power line off, and we're responsible for our own power, that's all off-grid is. We no longer rely on the utility company for power. And people that are typically interested in an off-grid system are generally motivated by being energy independent, whether they live in an area where there's a lot of rolling blackouts, or the utility is very, very high, or they just don't want to rely on someone else for their power needs. The main motivator behind being off-grid is energy independence and having control over your own power. And when it comes to applications for an off-grid setup, it probably has the widest variety of all of them. It can range from something small like a shed, a chicken coop, a pool house. It can go all the way up to an entire house, a farm, a business, a store. It could be something as dumb as what we're trying to do with this garage and just take the garage off grid. This is where we do all of our filming and working. And so if we cannot pay for the majority of our power by controlling the power that goes on inside of the garage in our entire house, that's also an application for off grid. The moral is you are not relying on anybody else. You're in control of your own power. The second type of application that you might run into is a hybrid system. Now, a hybrid system is a bit smarter of a system, and it is basically a bigger inverter that's able to communicate with the utility and the batteries that you have to decide where to get its power from to send it to your devices. In layman's terms, if you have a massive battery bank and you run out of battery, a hybrid inverter will just switch over and you'll start pulling power back from the grid and using that power until you have a chance to charge up those other batteries, either with solar or with AC from your wall. The typical motivators for this is saving money. Maybe you don't have a battery bank that's big enough to be completely off-grid, but the majority of your power is off-grid. Or peace of mind. We would use it in that instance because where we live, we sometimes go a week without sun. And so we could build a massive kit. There's always a chance that we're gonna run out of battery power in the middle of winter. And so if we had a hybrid system, we know that no matter what, even if we're completely out of batteries, we can always kick back on the grid, use power from the grid for the time being until we inevitably get sun back in our lives. Third application, and another really popular one that people use solar power for a lot, is emergency backup. And with emergency backup, you're basically just trying to capture and store energy that you can use when the grid is down. And the primary motivation or application for this is just peace of mind. A lot of people live in places where you have rolling blackouts or natural disasters or just terrible storms all the time. Even if you built a bunker and you're just waiting for the aliens to come, having an emergency backup solar power system can come quite handy. And when it comes to an emergency backup power system, it doesn't have to be crazy. You don't have to have a massive amount of batteries that can power your home indefinitely off-grid. What a lot of people like to do is they like to get it prepped so that you can run your essentials. So a lot of emergency backup kits are actually a little bit smaller when it comes to the battery and the inverter and the solar panel size, because what you're trying to do is when you have those blackouts or brownouts or storms, you want to keep things like your lights and your Wi-Fi router and your fridge running, but you don't necessarily need to be running your compressor or lifting your car up on a hoist during this period of time. But that doesn't mean you can't. You can also get an emergency backup system that is full jam and is able to power your entire house during these times. It really just depends how frequently you have disasters and what you're trying to be doing in the middle of these situations. We like to call that the luxuries. If you want to continue to run your AC, do laundry, cook in the oven, that kind of stuff is gonna require the bigger size system. And the fourth and final application is mobile or portable power. Now your mind might go straight to a portable power station, which obviously still applies to this, but you can actually use traditional kits for mobile and portable power as well. And the motivation for something like this would just be freedom and convenience and ultimately having power wherever you are. This is the kind of kit that you might see in an RV so that someone is able to harness the power of the sun and turn that into electricity that they can use while they're out traveling the world. You might see that in a food truck, you might see that at a construction site, or you might be looking as simple as just going overlanding. But regardless, there is a whole application to just having power in a location that you normally would not. And that's pretty much it. Those are the four main things that we see solar being used for a lot. And so now that you understand all the terms and you might have a better idea of where you're trying to go with solar, what your application is, it's time to get into the fun stuff where we actually build and properly size a solar power system, which is coming up in the next video. So if you guys learned something from this, make sure you share it with some friends. Otherwise, I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.